Donc vous avez certainement entendu parler des
ressources en énergie marine renouvelable.
Mais en fait,
renewable maritime resources.
Donc la première, c'est la ressource éolienne qui est associée
but
au vent.
First we have
la seconde, wind la ressource hydrolienne
provient
du
vent. The wind.
La troisième qu'on
then we have kinetic energy, tidal energy, then we have wave energy coming
la
from the waves. The fourth is thermal energy from the sea associated with the temperature difference between surface water and the bottom water, and osmotic difference in salinity between oceanic and continental water. Now, the wind resource is characterized by the fact that it is intermittent. Wind varies in time with altitude and space. Altitude variation is illustrated by the left-hand side graph. We can see that the wind decreases when we come closer to the ocean surface, and the decrease is associated with the friction when the wind runs on water surface. On the right-hand side, we see the average wind speed over 10 years at an altitude of 50 meters, and we see the main types of climate, the low pressure system at low and average, high and average altitude in red, and the trade wind systems at tropical latitudes in pink. Wind varies in space at finer scales. For instance, when there is a storm, wind variation will take place within a few kilometers scale. Time variation also may take different forms. It may vary over 24 hours, for instance, when there is a low pressure period, and then there can be a one-hour variation during a storm, or even 1 second when there is a gust of wind. Gusts are associated with the turbulences when wind rubs on the surface of the ocean. In order to illustrate space variations, I would like to show you these two pictures. On the left-hand side, this is a picture coming from a synthetic aperture radar deployed from a satellite showing wind variation on the ocean surface. We can observe that gravity waves are generated associated with the wind passing over the topography. The colors change from blue to green on the left-hand side picture. Models may be used, digital models, in order to characterize the space evolution of the wind field. On the right-hand side picture, we see the evolution in the wind field with a picture of a wind farm. Each little black line corresponds to a windmill, and the color matches the wind intensity. We see the wake associated to the windmills and the complex variations of the wind even within a wind farm. Now, the kinetic energy resource is more predictable, although it is still intermittent. Predictability is associated with the fact that the tidal wave only depends on astronomic forcing, the attraction between the moon and the sun and the Earth, that can be predicted in a very accurately. Tidal amplitude is limited by the coast configuration. We're talking about resonance phenomena or wave amplification, like in the Saint-Michel Bay, Mont-Saint-Michel Bay, or Fundy Bay in Canada. The current velocity is influenced by the bathymetry, or the shape of the sea bottom. We look for funnels because funnels with flow conservation will tend to increase speed. Just to illustrate time and space variations in tide currents, I would like to show you some illustrations. Here we have a measurement of the current made by a current profiling device showing the current evolution over several days. There are two big frequencies. The first one is a period of 12 hours, and the second, which is associated with the rising tide and ebbing tide cycle, is a 14-day oscillation. We see the modulation in the high frequencies associated with the cycle variations where neap tide alternate with spring tide. On the left-hand side, we see the current evolving depending on the sea bottom configuration, and we have the same sort of evolution that we have with the wind because the current will rub against the sea bottom. On the right-hand side, we have a digital model predicting the evolution of the tidal current on the French along the French coast, and in the previous slide, I showed you that the current is encouraged by a very specific coast shape and also by a specific bathymetry configuration. These parameters are brought together in two places in France, the Raz Blanchard, where the resource reaches 7 gigawatts, and Fontvert in Brittany, between the islands of Wesson and Banec, where we have an even greater resource. Kinetic energy or wave energy is also very interesting. Initially, the wind is intermittent, but here the resource is modulated by the depth for two reasons. When the waves reach the continental platform at a depth of 100 to 200 meters, they start rubbing against the bottom, dissipating energy. This phenomenon can be seen quite clearly on the map of the wave energy resources. We see the colors moving from orange to yellow and green and blue as we move closer to the coast.
Lorsqu'on arrive à une distance très proche de la côte, le processus de
at a very close distance to the coast, the wave breaking process will dissipate the energy over an even shorter distance.
La ressource motrice, elle peut être
now,
quantifiée
wave
par
energy resources can be quantified with two models,
models
either models or observations. For models,
spectro,
we have the spectral model and the deterministic model. The spectral
model
tries to show the evolution of the wave spectrum. The wave spectrum represents the wave energy depending on the direction and the frequency, whereas the deterministic model attempts to reproduce the evolution of the free surface anywhere. On the right-hand side picture, we see an evolution of the predicted surface with a deterministic model applied to the Hawaii island. On the left-hand side picture, we see the evolution of the wave height measured with a wave buoy, which was tied offshore near Brittany, and it went through a number of storms, and in some cases, the waves reached a record height. Individual waves reached 24 meters and even greater heights. This is one of the difficulties that project developers are facing when they want to develop a wave energy or tidal energy power plant model, except for thermal resources, which are normally installed in tropical areas which are less affected by climate events, except maybe typhoons. Maritime energies thermal energies are associated with the temperature difference between surface water and bottom water. Bottom water are at a temperature of 4 degrees, regardless of whether you are in the tropical areas or anywhere else. The difference comes from the surface areas, because surface water are warmed up by the sun, and this is even more marked when we reach the equator. Here we see a map that shows the development of the technology, whereas on the right-hand side we have the temperature profile for Martinique Island. We see here quite clearly that the temperature varies from 28 degrees on the surface to drop to 4 degrees near the bottom of the sea. One of the characteristics of maritime energies is that it is constant. Here, the temperature varies only by a few degrees from one season to the next in the tropical areas, but no more than a few degrees.